Hey everyone, in the previous lectures, we have discussed about wattmeters, that is electrodynamometer type wattmeter and induction type wattmeter. Now when we are using a normal wattmeter and the value of power factor is becoming in between 0.5 to 0.1, it is not able to show proper readings. Now for that purpose, we require a low power factor wattmeter. Now in today's lecture, we'll be discussing about how a normal wattmeter can be modified, what all special features has to be added to a normal wattmeter so that it can be made into a low power factor wattmeter. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about wattmeters. We have discussed about two type of wattmeters, that is electrodynamometer type wattmeter and induction type of wattmeter. Now these wattmeters will measure power. Now if a condition comes where the value of power factor is in between 0.5 to 0.1, in this condition the normal wattmeters that we are talking about, it will not be able to measure the powers. Now why it will not be able to measure powers? Because of these two factors. That is, the first factor is that the deflecting torque which is seen on the moving system, its value will become very small even if the current and pressure coils are fully excited, because we know that the deflecting torque, which is, it is directly proportional to IPI cos phi dm by d theta. Now when the value of power factor is becoming 0.1, now let us see an example. Let the value of IP be 10 and the value of IB 100. So this has to give that if the value of cos phi was equal to 1, I would have got 1000. That is, the torque produced, it would have been 1000 because of this 1000 quantity. Now similarly, the same case, now if the value of cos phi is becoming 0.1, this 1000, when the value of cos phi is 1, it will become 100. That is, it has considerably reduced. That is, it has become, the deflecting torque has reduced almost by 10 times. Now this is the first factor because of which a normal wattmeter, it cannot measure the proper power when cos factor, that is when the power value of power factor is very low. Now the second problem that can come is that is because of the errors which are introduced because the inductance of pressure coil, that is the error because of the inductance of pressure coils have very large values when the power factor value is low. We know that the error because of the inductance of pressure coil is VI sin phi tan beta. Now as I have earlier said, when the value of cos phi is equal to 1, that means almost, sorry, the value is 0.1, that means almost the 5 angle is near about 85 degree. Now sin 85, it will almost be nearer to 1, it will almost be approximately equal to 1. Because of that, this error quantity, it will also be very large. As the error quantity is very large and the value of deflecting torque is very low, deflecting torque's value is very low, and at the similar time the error quantity because of the inductance of pressure coil is very large, because of these two factors a normal wattmeter, it cannot measure power at low power factor. So therefore we have to make some modifications in the power factor, in the wattmeter. Now we'll be discussing what modifications can we make to a normal wattmeter to make it a low power factor wattmeter. Now for this discussion we are only taking the electrodynamometer type of wattmeter. Now for this we have to make four special features has to be added to any wattmeter. Now if we add these four special features to a wattmeter, that is to an electrodynamometer type wattmeter, it will become a low power factor wattmeter. Now let us look into what are the features. The first is the pressure coil current. Now the pressure coil current is designed to have low values of resistance. That is, compared to the normal wattmeter, in the low power factor wattmeter, what we will do is the pressure coil, that or the shunt coil as we used to say, or the voltage coil, its resistance value will be very low. So when I am reducing the value of resistance of the pressure coil, what will happen? The current that is flowing through this, its value will increase. Now when the value of current is increasing, I will get an increased operating torque. So as we have seen, IPI cos phi dm by d theta, it was the deflecting torque. Now what I am doing is I am trying to increase the value of this IP. Now when the value of IP is increased because of cos phi, the value was getting reduced. Now what I am doing is I am trying to increase the value of IP. So when I am trying to increase the value of IP, it will somehow, to some extent, it will compensate for the effect because of the low power factor. Now here we can see that the pressure coil current in a low power factor wattmeter may be almost as 10 times higher. That is, as we have seen, if the cos phi becomes low, it will reduce or the deflecting torque's value almost by 10 times. Now what we are doing, the resistance is such adjusted in such a manner that it becomes whatever current is flowing across the pressure coil, its value will increase by 10 times than the normal wattmeter. That is, if in normal wattmeter, if the value of current in pressure coil is IP, for a low power factor wattmeter, it will become 10 times of IP. How I am getting this? I am reducing the resistance value of the pressure coil. So this is the first technique that I'll be using. That is, if this is my wattmeter, to my wattmeter's pressure coil, I'll reduce the resistance of the pressure coil. Now the second feature that we have to add is compensation for pressure coil current. Now when I'm talking about this, now the amount of current flowing through the pressure coil has increased. Now let us look at this connection. This is the first connection. There are two type of connections that we can make in between a current coil and a pressure coil. Now let us look into this. Now this is the first type of connection. In the first type of connection, we can see here that whatever current is drawn here is I plus IP. What that is? The increased value. That is, pressure coil is drawing more current. As I have reduced the resistance, pressure coil is now trying to draw more current. Now because of that, the current will be I plus IP. Now for example, if my load, it was consuming 10 watts, now it will become 12 watts. Why it will become 12 watts? It will become 12 watts because my instrument itself has started drawing extra current. Now this is the first case scenario. Now here also we can see here that the current coil, it will show the value of I plus IP. Why I plus IP? Because extra pressure coil is drawing extra current, that is, compared to the normal wattmeter, it is drawing extra current. Now the second type of connection that I can do is, now here what I'll do is I'm just changing the position of pressure coil. The pressure coil was connected here, the pressure coil's connection is just changed. Now when I'm changing the position of pressure coil, the current flowing to the load is I, but this pressure coil is also showing, that is, the voltage drop across this pressure coil will be this and this. That is the combined effects of both this. That is, combined effect of both this, it will be seen in this first case. In the second case, only voltage drop across this and the current, current coil will be showing current that is flowing through both the elements. Now in both these conditions, we can see that the error that is introduced, that is, because of increased current flowing in the pressure coil, the error that is introduced, that error cannot be compensated. Now for compensating that, what we will do is, to the current coil, that is, in series to the current coil, we will add a compensating coil. Now what this compensating coil will do is, for example, if my extra current, that is, pressure coil is taking, for example, initially the current flowing was I, now after reducing the resistance of pressure coil, the current flowing is now I plus IP, that is, an extra amount of IP current is flowing. Now what this compensating coil will do is, this compensating coil will, because of mutual induction, this compensating coil will also allow IP current to flow through this. Now the current coil and compensating coil are connected in such a manner that compensating coil will oppose current coil. That is, if the value of current coil, that is, current flowing across through current coil is I plus IP, compensating coil will also induce amount of current IP. This will be in opposition. So plus IP minus IP will get cancelled, and my current coil will only be showing the value I. So this is the second feature that we have to add. The third feature that we have to add is that compensation for the inductance of pressure coil. Now as we have already discussed, that is, error. The error component is VI sin phi tan beta. Now here we can see that the error caused by the pressure coil inductance, that is VI sin phi tan beta, with low power factor value of phi, it will be very large. Why? Because if the value of power factor is almost equal to 0.1, that means that sine phi's value will always be approximately equal to 1. So because of that, the error introduced will be very large. Now, in order to reduce that is in a low power factor meter, we must compensate for the error caused by the inductance of the pressure coil. This is done just by connecting opposition of inductance can be done using a capacitor. So what we'll do is to the resistor's small component, I'll be adding a capacitor. Now this capacitor is connected to a part of the series resistance of the pressure coil. Now what this will oppose whatever effects are there because of the inductance of this. So inductance and capacitance, both what we'll do is both will oppose each other. As these are opposing each other, the compensation for the inductance in the pressure coil is achieved. Now the fourth factor that we have to modify is that we have to go for small control torques. That is, we have to design this instrument in such a manner that is, even if small values of deflecting torque is present, the instrument should start rotating. That is, in the low power factor wattmeters, it are designed so that even with a small torque, it gives full scale deflections. That is, even if the value of power factor is equal to 1, it will move from 0 to full scale, that is with the value of power factor to be 0.1. So this is the other modification that we have to make. So by modifying or by adding these four modifications, we can make any normal wattmeter into a low power factor wattmeter. Looking at this diagram, we can clearly remember the what are all the points required for a low power factor wattmeter. The first point, as we have discussed, that is the pressure coil resistance will be low. The second point, that is for compensation of the current flowing through the pressure coil, compensating coil will be used. The third, that is to compensate the pressure coil inductance, we'll be using a capacitor that is connected in shunt across a portion of the series resistance. Then the fourth point is that is for small torque operation, that is even if the value of power factor is very low and small torques are produced, I'll get full scale deflections I'll be getting. Now these are the four points. Keeping this diagram in mind, we can remember all these four points. Now one thing we have to keep in mind is that the low power factor meter, it is used for measuring the power of highly inductive circuit, and it is also used for resistive circuit which has a power factor in the range from 0.5 to 1. And a modern low power factor wattmeter, it is designed in such a manner that it will give high accuracy even while measuring power factors which are lower than 0.1.